All right, thanks for joining us. I'm Dr. Stacy Worley, in an episode of Real Talk with Officer Males of Color. Today with me, I have Mr. Marlon Shackelford, our lead coordinator, and I have Mr. Jerry Hahn, our life coach, and Mr. Abdeen Lewis, our life coach. Today, we just want to share with you some things that the Officer Males of Color have done, and we just want to invite you to explore some of the discussions that we want to have today. So I'm going to tip it off and share with you, let you get to hear from Mr. Marlon Shackelford.
First of all, I'm glad to be here, and those that are viewing, that we need you to know, for an Office for the Males of Color, that we really care about you being successful. And we want you to be great. I think it's a difference between success and being great. We want you to be great because great people help others. And that's what the MOC is about, the Males of Color helping others. And make sure that we're not poor students. Internet has a slang which they call POOR, which is an acronym, and that acronym means passing over opportunities repeatedly. We cannot be poor students. We look at the five P's to counter that, which is prior preparation prevents poor performance. So we don't want you to be poor. We're here to help you. ESOP would say be prepared. We want you to be prepared. You can ask us the questions. You can ask us the hard questions. We are truly here to help you and make you better so that our community can be better. So that's just my lead in.
And Mr. Jerry Hahn.
Yes. We want you to know that we deep down, we care for your students, we care for your families, and that we're here for you no matter what you, whatever you need.
And Mr. Abdeen Lewis.
All right, we want to let you know that we're a community, a brotherhood. Everyone needs someone to lean on at some point in life. And so when you can tap into a community resources, then you know that regardless of what you deal with in life, you can make it through. Be that going through a pandemic, be that struggling academically, be that feeling alienated from not being able to have the same social group. Whatever it is, you kind of find that relief and that guidance through a community. And so that's what we hope to be here at the Office of Males of Color. So I'm happy to be here.
With the Office of Males of Color, I would like to say we are in all 24 of our schools from grades 4 through 12, and we try to make sure we increase our young men's attendance, improve their grades, and just get rid of some of the behavior issues that they may have in school and without in the community and in their homes. Today we want to discuss how do you prepare your students for a pandemic in school and in the community. So we're going to talk about that today, and I want to lead off with Mr. Lewis.
So I think, you know, that one is an interesting question given where we are right now in the state of the pandemic, and at this point, you know, being November in 2020, and now the state has issued, a stay-at-home order, and then the school has made the decision to not just, not even to go virtual, but to postpone 15 days of the school year till June. And so in terms of how do you support, I think that it's important to think about what this current condition means for students. I think that's where we have to start kind of framing that, because students have gone from one in the spring having to shift to virtual learning, which was new for everybody, right? Before they were in school, and that's what they were accustomed to. And so then they switched in the spring to virtual learning for whatever that couple months were, and then went a whole summer, you know, in most situations, right, if I can say that, not being academically, not being in school. And then they got back late or early September into a hybrid kind of situation. Actually, I think we started virtual?
Yeah, it was virtually.
We started virtually, and then that transitioned to hybrid. So I think that, first of all, we have to understand that students have been in this space of trying to accommodate and trying to adjust repeatedly and repeatedly. And that's not even undermining other situations that they could have dealt with family, with, you know, the COVID situation. So our students have really faced a lot so far. So I think supporting has to start from what have they dealt with, and then what can we do to support moving forward. So I think that's where I start the conversation.
And I think that's really important, because the biggest thing you can do, as you ask, preparing for a pandemic, is to think about what can you do to support your students during that time. Because the reality of it is, no one can actually prepare for what a pandemic is actually going to look like. Mm-hmm. Because I don't think anyone expected to go from March to September and not be able to just physically be engaging with students. You know, in March, the most you had was a phone call or a video chat. And then for them to have to experience that at the beginning of September, it's a lot, especially when you talk about some of our kids who enjoy that face-to-face, giving their teacher a hug, or just sitting down and be able to, hey, come here, sit right here, I want to talk to you for a minute. And now they can't do that because everybody has to be, you know, 6 feet apart. It's tough.
So what are your thoughts on this?
Your brother said it very eloquently to me. I would say, don't let the pandemic stop you from dreaming. For those that are watching, we are not just human beings. We're human becoming. We're becoming whatever we want to be. You know, and another thing that I always say, we're not human beings, we're dream beings, so we're always dreaming. And why that's important, even if you're at home, if you're at home and you're in your bubble, create that bubble where you can become successful. You got Google, you already in that space. Give 125% even at home. I mean, even with the classroom, the virtual classroom, give 125%. When you're at school, I've been blown away by this whole school thing, because I'm, you know, here at Ponis and I was at Stivers. It was like, the ratio was like 5 kids to 1 teacher. Wow, where they do that at? That's awesome. So if you was a young person, those teachers was in there giving 125%. Take advantage of the moment. Take advantage of the moment. I mean, learn, baby, learn. That's one of the things they used to say in the 60s. Read, baby, read. Take advantage, because you're there. It's just you and that teacher. You should be able to really learn more, not less. So I guess my first message would be, if there was a messaging taking place, take advantage of the moment, because C plus B equals A. I really believe this. What you conceive, if you believe, you can achieve. So in a bubble, or at the school, take advantage. You can go up leaps and bounds. You can take quantum leaps by just paying attention to the teacher and wanting to be great.
Mr. Lewis, can you share with us some of the things that we do at Office of Males of Color to engage our young men during this pandemic?
Absolutely. So one of the things, and I think Brother Shaq, you kind of alluded to, or maybe spoke on, is that you have a different kind of situation at school where the class sizes are smaller. Not only that, you have the school resources, but now that it's less people, and I'm talking about in a hybrid situation where we have less people actually in the school building, students still have the same access to those individuals. So with the Office of Males of Color, us being in the support capacity for students, we end up being able to do one-on-ones with students. So like for my school, EJ Brown and Fairview, I've been able to, before we even switched to hybrid, when we were on virtual, I was able to come in during what they call small group and pull out students and do one-on-ones. And that was so valuable, because students were like, I'm seen. I'm noticed. Someone is taking the time to pause and say, what's going on in your world? Show that you care, you know? So that's one of the things I think gives us that unique positioning as Office of Males of Color, because we're someone that they can probably identify with, for those who identify as male, a black male. Even for those who didn't identify as black male, because I had some that were different identities, and that was totally fine, because they were like, well, here's an identity that I don't always see, and taking interest in me. And so that shapes the narrative around around how Black males interact and the ways in which we can be valuable in the school system. So that's one. And I just want to touch on one more, because I think that you all also have examples of ways in which MOC benefits the school system, Dayton Public School System. But one is providing that social environment. So students have said, and you touched on this, Brother Shaq, students have said that being in school is different than when they were used to because they could talk to their friends. And you talked mm-hmm. about this, huh? Mm-hmm. You know, they got to stay 6 feet away. So they can't be all goofy and tell their little secrets and stuff like they used to do school, right? Yeah. And build that community. But now with the, you know, staying 6 feet makes it complicated. But we, during in a virtual setting, we were able to do a game night. We were able to provide after-school enrichment and involve them in one-on-ones, but in the capacity of talking about academics, talking about, you know, what a success plan looks like. And so we've been able to be, you know, very engaging with students, even during the pandemic and during the hybrid situation.
And I think what's great about what you said is sometimes when we see our students, now we see our boys in our group of students that we work with, but then you have other students who you may not work with who see you care for another student was like, mm-hmm. I like that. And then they gravitate toward you because they know that if you care about them, then you'll care about me too. Mm-hmm. And that is what makes the program so great, is because we get to actually show students, you know, I care about you beyond
School,
you know.
And Jerry, if I may, I love where this is going. I want to tell you just how real that statement is in terms of other students seeing and wanting to be part of that group
that's seen and felt.
I had a group of, when I was at Fairview, I was pulling students out, right, one-on-ones, and every time before I do it, the teacher would come on and say, hey, we got Mr. Lewis in the space. And then I would always come on full of energy. Hey guys, I'm so glad to be here. You guys, you're rocking it, you're killing it. You know, I would just be that energy. And then I would pull out certain guys and then I would have conversations with them. They would come back in the class and they'd tell their friends, yeah, I'm going with Mr. Lewis and such. It to the point where one time I came on and the students were messaging the teacher saying, am I going with Mr. Lewis today? Am I going with Mr. Lewis today? Mm-hmm. To the point where they had to make an announcement and saying, he's going to pull out guys every, you know, he has a schedule,
right,
and he'll send out and let you know exactly when he's going to pull you out, but everybody's not going to go all at the same time, which just, I think, speaks to the need to have our representation and
right.
the need to have student voice be illuminated.
Mm-hmm. And to add, Doc, something else we did, Males of Color, in August, that we helped pass out food mm-hmm. to at least 500 to 600 families weekly. I think that's real powerful. And also, we went and got young men haircuts.
Yeah.
To date, maybe about 20, 25 different young men have got their haircuts. I can't shout out the barbers. I didn't get his okay. But we got some men in the community that's cutting these young men's hair for free. I think that's real awesome. So one of the things that we do at Males of Color, we are definitely thinking outside of the box and hopefully one day to be able to eliminate the box. But we're thinking outside of the box inside of a circle. And a circle just simply represents a community. And that's what I love about Males of Color over the last couple years, where there's been indicators that's proven that we have been a success, is that we're thinking outside of that box. So let me share this. Don't quit, get help. That's for a young person that you're out there. We are the help. We are here. Some of us are 24/7. That's right, 24/7. Me and Doc sometimes talking 3:30 in the morning, as well as Devin Terry talking about solutions, talking about being a part of the solution by any positive means necessary. So I'm just saying that we're real innovative, we're real flexible. And if you got a young son, because I think we're in 24 schools.
Yeah,
if you got a young son, I'm telling you, you want to get him involved. You want to get him involved. We have a great group of guys we're working with. And can somebody shout their names out? I think it would be an injustice not to mention some of the men that we're working with.
What we got? We got Robert Brown, Derek Moss, Tony White, Darian Howard, Jerron Brooks. Just all great guys.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And, you know, it's like you said, Brother Shaq, just the willingness to go above and beyond for the students that you care about. Mm-hmm. And just have them see that you care about you. It's a feeling that you'll never get enough of. Mm-hmm. You always want more of it because you always know that you're helping somebody.
Mm-hmm. And while you're on that topic, Mr. Hahn, why don't you share with them some of the activities that we've done, even during the mm-hmm. pandemic?
I think, yeah, of course. Brother Abdeen mentioned it. You know, we was able to do game night, had 50 boys sign up to, you know, just virtually play video games with us. We was able to take 30 boys fishing, which was amazing because, you know, even though it was cold, just to see the boys out there experiencing something that they don't normally get to do, you know, that was amazing.
And we took the gentleman out to golf with the commissioner Jeff Mims.
You know, activities like that that our boys don't normally get to engage in can change their perspective mm-hmm. on a lot of things. Like, yo, I can go fishing? Yep. You know, a lot of guys that went was like, this is my first time fishing. I don't even know what to do. I'm like, come on, man, just put the worm on the hook. It ain't that big mm-hmm. of a deal. But, you know,
yeah,
it was new to them because they had never done it. And then once they get the hang of it, it's like, oh, this is really cool. You know, even to have young men catch fish was, you know, exciting because they're like, I don't know what to do. Who gonna get this fish off this hook? Mm-hmm. So it was fun. It was very fun.
Yeah, we had a great time. And we also had, I have to mention, Keith Byers was there with us. So they had opportunity to really meet with Keith Byers, a Hall of Famer, and have a dialogue with him and get to know him on a personal level. So that was very, a great time for these young men to experience that. So one of the things, we just want to give you a glimpse of what Males of Color does for DPS and how we engage our young boys and our young students even during the pandemic. I would say before we wrap up with Real Talk that, you know, have candid conversations with your young people. They may have some anxieties and fears about some of the things that they're going through. And if you don't have the answer, let them know you don't have the answer. It's okay. But I think if we'll be open and honest with them, they will adapt. And they will adjust and they will make it in a very positive manner. But just know that the Males of Color is here to assist all our young men in every DPS school. So if you have a young student out there, a young man that wants to be a part of it, reach out to the principals, reach out to any one of our life coaches here or those that we mentioned earlier, and we'll be happy to allow them to join us. And we will be back again with Real Talk, and I'm Dr. Stacy Worley, and thank you for joining us.